Hello everyone, my name is Naveen Desai and today I will be telling you some important aspects related to your embryology report. Now, embryology report is a very important part of your IVF cycle because it gives you the detail about what has been done on your gametes, be it your eggs, your sperms, or the further development of the embryos. So here are quick things that you should check in your embryology report. A, first and foremost, please ensure to check the name and age of yourself and your partner on it. So that means you know that this is your report. Okay. Then comes the next detail about how many eggs have been retrieved. How many mature eggs did you get out of the retrieved total number of eggs? What was the semen analysis, details in it? And then how many eggs actually fertilized using your sperms? What was the development of the embryos and what date or what day of the development of those embryos were. Also, depending upon the laboratory's practice, whether they do a day 3 cycle or a day 5 cycle, remember to see how many out of these day 3 embryos were either transferred or remainder were frozen or completely all of them were frozen, and they were frozen on how many cryo devices. Vis-a-vis or for day 5, see how many embryos or how many blastocysts rather were frozen, and if, for example, certain embryos did not reach the blastocyst stage or the day 3 stage, then what happened about these embryos? So remember to have all these details. There might be certain labs which might not have a software in place to give you a report. It doesn't matter. Just ask the laboratory or the clinic to give you this detail on maybe their letterhead, so that it just makes it more authentic. If at all they happen to go to another clinic, if they have a failed cycle or if they want to undertake IVF services maybe 2 years down the line again or 3 years down the line again for having another child. So an embryology report is a very important element, not just for yourself but also for the consulting doctor whom you're visiting maybe after a failed cycle or for your subsequent child that you may want to have. So remember to have these details, and please make a note of the details about your frozen embryos, because these are the embryos which you can utilize at a later stage without undergoing a complete new cycle. You already have some embryos in storage, so don't forget about them. Keep a constant update on them, and get in touch or keep in touch with the clinic to understand whether they have still stored your embryos or they have not. A detailed emphasis on this entire report you can find on our website. So please do visit our website, which is www.virtuousfertility.com. If you further have any details, please feel free to contact us by emailing us on info@virtuousfertility.com, and we will be really, really very happy to reciprocate in the best possible way. Thank you for listening, and see you soon on the next video.